In this video, let us discuss about diaphragm. So first, let us draw the diaphragm. Okay, so actually this is a diagram which is if you enter into the abdomen and if you see from below side, okay, so this is how the diaphragm looks. So this is a diaphragm which you look from the below side, okay, from the lower side. Okay, so first let us see what is actually why we are studying diaphragm, for what it is useful. Diaphragm is a chief muscle of quiet inspiration. Okay, so it is a chief muscle for quiet inspiration, sorry, quiet respiration. Okay, and if you see, it is like a dome shaped structure. Okay, it is a dome shaped muscle, and these muscles are like a periphery of partition. They're like an acting as a partition for a thorax above and below abdomen, right? So let us see the origin of this. Actually, if you come to the origin of the diaphragm muscles, it is divided into three types. That is, the first one is sternal origin, and the second one is the costal origin, and the third one is lumbar origin. So of course you can imagine, sternal means it will be on the front side. So the sternal origin is coming from the scyphoid process, okay, from the scyphoid process. And the costal origin is coming from lower six ribs inner surface. So for example, this is a diaphragm. So this anterior side, this side, it is coming from the sternal or scyphoid process. And sides, this is a costal side. The costal side is coming from the lower six ribs inner surface. Okay. And lumbar, lumbar means on back side. Okay. Lumbar side is coming from, it is coming from the right medial and lateral, by medial and lateral lumbocostal arches. Okay, lumbocostal arches, and which are in turn coming from lumbar vertebra. Okay, from lumbar vertebra by right and left crest. So actually this right and left crest are present on posterior side. So whenever in the diaphragm, if you see this crest, means it is a posterior side. So this is the anterior side of the diaphragm. Okay, so once again, let us revise the origin of diaphragm muscles. The first one is from the sternal side. Sternum side, it is coming from scyphoid process. Costal sides, on the sides, it is coming from the lower six ribs inner surface. And lumbar one, which is coming from the medial and lateral lumbocostal arches, that is nothing but from the lumbar vertebra by forming a right and left crest on the posterior side. So all this, now all this sternal, costal, lumbar origins, all will go and they will insert into a central tendon. So this is a central tendon. So all the muscle fibers which are coming here, they will come and they will go to the central tendon and insert there. So the insertion is a central tendon, okay. Now it's time to discuss about the arcuate ligaments. So first, this is a medial arcuate ligament, okay. So what is this arcuate ligament? The medial arcuate ligament is nothing but it is a tendineous arch which is like covering upper part of psoas major. Actually, the upper part of psoas major muscle only convert as a medial arcuate ligament. So the medial arcuate ligament is nothing but coming from the psoas major muscle, okay. And it is attached to the body of L1 vertebra. So it is attached to L1 vertebra, and it is also continuous with lateral margin of the crest. So you can see it is continuous with the lateral margin of the crest of diaphragm. Okay. And laterally, it is attached to front of transverse process. It is attached to L1, we already said, but where in L1? It is attached to transverse process in L1. Okay, so it is attached to transverse process in L1. Now let us discuss about lateral arcuate ligament. So just next to the medial arcuate ligament, laterally you'll have the lateral arcuate ligament. So from which muscle it is coming? Lateral arcuate ligament is coming from quadratus lumborum muscle. Okay, quadratus lumborum muscle. So from quadratus lumborum muscle, there is origin of lateral arcuate ligament, and this lateral arcuate ligament will attach to the 12th rib. Okay, so it is attached medially to the lower part of 12-3 and also to the transverse process of L1. So it is also attached to L1 transverse process. Okay. So to lumbar 1 vertebra. So this is the medial and lateral ligaments, lateral arcuate ligaments. Medial arcuate ligament coming from psoas major muscle, lateral arcuate ligament coming from quadratus lumborum muscle. Now let us discuss the different openings of diaphragm. So first we need to understand at which level what is opening. So the first opening we are going to talk is about the inferior vena cava opening. Okay, so inferior vena cava opening is at the level of 8th thoracic vertebra. Okay, and next coming to other opening, that is our esophageal opening. And the esophageal opening is at the level of 10th thoracic vertebra. So TV here represents thoracic vertebra. And next coming to the aortic opening. The aortic opening is at the level of 12th thoracic vertebra. So we are coming in order from 8, 10, 12. Okay, IOA. So in the diaphragm, if you mark them, here will be your inferior vena cava opening at the level of, you should say now, at the level of 8th thoracic vertebra. Okay, and here you will be having a esophageal opening, and esophageal opening is at the level of 10th thoracic vertebra, and exactly here this one is the aortic opening, and aortic opening is at the level of 12th thoracic vertebra. Now we need to check out what are the other structures which are passing in these openings. So first we'll start with inferior vena cava. So in 8th thoracic vertebral opening, of course in the inferior vena cava opening, inferior vena cava will be present. Okay, that is the first structure. So what are the other ones? There is also presence of phrenic nerve, especially right phrenic nerve. Okay, there is right phrenic nerve, and also there is lymphatics. Okay, so that's it. So to remember this, you can remember a mnemonic, that is IPL. So remember that IPL is at 8 o'clock. So like that you can remember. Why? Because at 8th thoracic vertebral level opening, you are having this all structures, that is inferior vena cava, phrenic nerve and the lymph, especially remember the right phrenic nerve. Now coming to esophageal opening. So for the esophageal opening, of course the esophageal will be present, esophagus will be present here, and along with that there are also some other structures, like you are having the gastric or vagus nerves. Okay, gastric or vagus nerve, that too esophageal branch. Okay, and also you will be having a left gastric artery, and also with that some esophageal veins. So to remember this, you can remember OGG. Okay, like EGG egg, OGG. OGG is at 10. Okay, OGG. O for esophagus, of course, G for gastric artery, another G for gastric nerve or vagus nerve. Okay, so like that you can remember this. Now coming to 12th thoracic vertebral level opening, of course it's aortic opening, there will be aorta in it. So other than aorta, there are some other structures, like you're having a thoracic duct here. Okay, you're having thoracic duct and also a zygous vein. So to remember this, you can remember ATA at 12 o'clock. So like this, IPL at 8 o'clock, OGG at 10 o'clock, OTA at 12. So if by remembering this mnemonics, we can easily remember the structures which are in the 8th thoracic vertebral level opening, which are in 10th thoracic level opening, which are in 12th thoracic vertebral level opening. So these are the different openings of diaphragm. Now let us also discuss some small openings. There are also some small openings in diaphragm. So for example, you have first one, that is the crust of diaphragm is pierced by lesser and greater splanchnic nerves. Okay, lesser and greater splanchnic nerves, they p pierce the crust of diaphragm. Okay, and next other one is sympathetic chain. Sympathetic chain pass from thorax to abdomen behind medial arcuate ligament. Okay, so these are some important points. And next coming to other one, that is subcostal nerve and vessel. They pass behind lateral arcuate ligament. Okay, and next you have superior epigastric vessels, and they pass between scyphoid process and seventh costal cartilage, where there is origins of diaphragm, and this gap is also called as Larynx space of foramen morgagni. So these are like some of the important landmarks. And next coming to other one, that is a musculophrenic vessels. So this pierce the diaphragm at 8th or 9th costal cartilage. Okay, they pierce diaphragm. So these are like some of the small openings into the diaphragm. Like first you have lesser greater splanchnic nerve in the crust of diaphragm. Next you have sympathetic chain behind medial arcuate ligament. You have subcostal nerve and vessel behind lateral arcuate ligament. You have superior epigastric vessels between scyphoid and seventh costal cartilage. And this place is also called as Larynx space of foramen morgagni. And musculophrenic vessels are at the level of 8th or 9th costal cartilage. They are piercing the diaphragm. So these are the small openings of the diaphragm. So the major openings of diaphragms are, of course, are inferior vena cava, esophagus and aorta. Now let us discuss the nerve supply of diaphragm. So which is supplying? Of course, the phrenic nerve. The phrenic nerve supply the diaphragm. The whole sole motor nerves of diaphragm are phrenic nerves. So especially C3, C4, C5. So by this we have completed all the important points of diaphragm. So first we have discussed about the origins of diaphragm, insertion into central tendon. Okay, next we have discussed about the openings of diaphragm, and also we have discussed the small openings of diaphragm.